Pause, please.
Maybe I'd like to move out of the big city of Toronto and come and live in the territories.
So as part of my research, I booked a flight using my Canadian Airways points to come to Yellowknife in the winter to check out that sort of weather and see how I like that, and also to have a chat with Catherine to find out what I would need to do to become a recreation director, because I was actually, I've been teaching swimming for about 18 years and I was really tired of having to shave my legs all the time. Excuse me. Anyway, a friend in Toronto lent me a parka. She said, it was February, she said, your regular coat won't do, you'll need this. So I came to Yellowknife armed with a parka. Of course, there was a blizzard blowing when the plane landed, and I was really surprised to have to walk across the tarmac. After all, it was a city, so where was the, you know, the covered walkway? What I noticed walking around Yellowknife was that people were, it was minus 25, I think, people were going around with their coats open, and I was zipping up very carefully every time I stepped outside. And it wasn't until after I lived here that I realized they'd done all their week of minus 40, and minus 25 was feeling quite good. Whereas for me, coming from Toronto, it felt really cold. However, it was enough to show me it's really beautiful, and I enjoyed seeing the Northern Lights, and decided that yes, I would like to come and live here. So I went back to school and studied recreation leadership, and in 1994 I drove north and did one last summer at the Pool of Port Providence, and then got a job as a recreation director in Wati. Wati is quite handy, it's quite close to Yellowknife, and I came out on a regular basis. And I thought Yellowknife must be a really small city, because each time I came, I would see the same person. He had a shock of white hair, and he wore a red parka and carried a briefcase under his arm. Each time I came, I saw the same guy, and I thought, there can't really be very many people here, because you can always see the same ones. It was actually Bill Reed, it turns out. And after several times of seeing him, then didn't actually see him anymore and realized there were more than a few people in the honor. While I was living in Wati, one weekend I was in town here and went to the swimming pool. I was shocked that I qualified for a senior's rate. I was in my 50s at the time. I don't know whether they've changed that now, but well, for a start, I hated to pay for swimming, because when you work at swimming pools, you never have to pay. You just swim when there's some free time. So I was quite happy, actually, to admit that maybe I was a little older and I do qualify for the seniors rate. But I think that was the first time I faced that issue. After my 2 years in Wati, I moved to Yellowknife in 1997 and had a short-term job with Yellowknife's Denny. After that, I bought a bed and breakfast and settled down to become a Yellowknifer. I thought I would run the bed and breakfast for 3 years or so, and then I would move on. Well, the 3 years actually turned into 14 years. Although I've now retired from that. For the longest time, I was in denial about this seniors business, and I only joined the senior society so that I could take advantage of the opportunity to go curling on Monday afternoons. While doing that, one day I was talking to one of the members of this group, and she said, well, why don't you sign up for the 55 plus games? They have a curling team. And I'm not really very good at curling, but I thought it'd be a good way of getting to the game, so I said I'd do it. Well, subsequently, somebody dropped out of the curling team, so I couldn't do that, so they asked if I'd do something else. I said, yes, okay, I would swim, and so that's what I tend to do at the games now. But it was joining this group that was going to the games that got me to really recognize that I am a senior, and they had a send-off lunch for us. So that was my first visit to lunch with the bunch. And then when we came back, there was a welcome back party or something. So after that, I've become a regular attender and a much more active member in the seniors. I have retired from the bed and breakfast business, but I'm still in Yarmouth, even though I have absolutely no family members here. My daughter lives in England, and my son is in Singapore. So I can't live close to both of them, so I may as well stay here where I have a good group of friends, and I really enjoy the lifestyle. And Yarmouth has changed quite a lot. I remember the excitement in 1992 because McDonald's was being built. And a short time after that, not only did they have one McDonald's, but suddenly there were two because Walmart took over Wilco. I think before that, the only fast food you could get was Kentucky Fried Chicken or Chinese. Anyway, Yarmouth's a great place to live. And oh yeah, yesterday I participated in the garden party at City Hall. Unfortunately, it was the last one, but it was the first one I've been to. And this made me realize what a great city this is to live in when they can organize really neat events like that. Anyway, I'm sure I've run out of time here, so I'll pass it over for the next person. Thank you.
Thank you very much, John.
She's actually going to the first one.